Hello, I am Liviu Popasimil, and I will present the molecular band terahertz detection and imaging structures with applications in many parts of life, from molecular visualization to biochemistry, chemistry, virology, and technical application and safety, security, and science research. I am an executive director at Los Alamos Academy of Sciences and the president of LAVMLSC in Los Alamos. I am a nuclear engineer and physicist, and research scientist, initially for Los Alamos National Laboratory and now for these private companies. For more information on me, please feel free to look on the website and do a search on internet. Well, from Star Trek, we had Internet of Things versus Big Data integration and very futuristic views of a device called Tricorder, which applied in a sick bay and make a non-invasive detection of almost all the sicknesses and anomalies in the body. Well, in the movie, it was also augmented by paranormal skills of some characters there. But I'm talking only about this advanced technology and maybe possible in the future to make direct data to brain transfer in order to increase computer to human communication, making a kind of cyborg. Well, terahertz is a part of electromagnetic spectrum and is not well covered today by the actual technology because the devices that are working microwaves have hard time switching and working in a terahertz domain, while the devices working in visible and near infrared has also hard time detecting terahertz because it is at a very low energy, photons in milli electron volt, and is out of both, it's in the middle of the both domains of electronics and optics, and this device comes to mitigate this gap. From the various point of view, you have Raman spectroscopy, terahertz detection and far infrared or Fourier transform infrared, and molecules like velodipine have a complex spectrum in infrared and have various contributions of various oscillation eigenmodes inside the molecules, and depending on temperature, the molecular bond strengths, and the proximity to other molecules and the interface. Basically, the movements are internal, rotation, translation, and vibrations, symmetric molecular displacements. There are many cases of molecules, and there are eigenmodes of vibration, like this is water molecule vibration, and has about three eigenmodes, and these are manifested in molecular spectrum, as well as a difference for carbon dioxide that has a linear structure instead of an angle structure as in water, and that has different eigenmodes that will have different vibration bands. When you look at more complex structures as uranium oxide and in reaction with nitrogen and water, we see various vibration modes that are contributions from various nitrogen combination, carbon dioxide, and also uranium oxide contributions that gives you fundamental frequency in the lower and upper band, but you need a high resolution detection in order to decide what really is and what is the contribution coming from. Well, in a more larger view, you have the atmospheric transmission bands and attenuation, so where attenuation is minimum in electromagnetic waves from few megahertz to few gigahertz, you obtain a good transmission through the atmosphere. Then the absorption bands of oxygen, water, carbon dioxide appears, and the transmission is reduced, so you got a lot of absorption. And this is a Planck spectrum that depends on the temperature. And so you have many applications in terahertz domain. I will not enter all because but some applications are in low terahertz, 1 to 3 terahertz, for transmissions through the closing and security imaging, or could be also medical imaging. And you may have a multispectral comparison of various bands, depends on how many bands and of detection you have and how narrow they are. You have a remote sensor, like a multispectral thermal imager, that is good for application. In our case, we use electromagnetic waves and a resonant input structure that is three times larger than the wavelength, and has a parametric amplifier that basically changes the resistors and amplifies the current from space impedance of 377 ohm to the field effect transistor gate impedance of few mega ohms, and the voltage is increased by effect of charge polaron amplification. Another device detects the anomaly, so the terahertz voltage is not able to switch actual electronic device, but is able to perturb it, and this perturbation is detected and is further differentiated in delay time digital analog converter that has basically no dead time and may go up to few gigasamples per second, as large as electronics is reliable to do that. And this is a schematic drawing of the detection module that detects a single frequency and digitizes it, fulfilling memory bank with fast direct access and even mode storage. For details on how the parametric amplification is happening is based on electric field behavior and creating polarons, charges that are polarized due to electric field, and implicit due to shape, spherical shape, is giving electric field amplification, while the impedance is growing. You have about energy or power conservation until it reaches the gate of a field effect transistor, and in a non-linear amplification characteristic, it gives a distortion to the signal. If you pass a reference signal and you disturb with the terahertz, you'll get a disturbed signal that is different from the initial signal, and that is what electronics can detect, and this is how the amplification takes place, subtracting the difference and then amplifying it and applying to further stages. In another view, this is a resonant element that is in contact with air or vacuum and has input impedance of 377 ohms, and each stage is giving an increase in impedance, and that means an increase in voltage until it gets a high voltage able to disturb low current or single electron field effect transistor, where the difference is detected and amplified and is transmitted to an analog digital converter. Everything is smaller than an actual discrete transistor on LED, and being an electromagnetic resonance structure, it can be placed in polarized mode, where you have a longitudinal or transversal polarization of the wave, or circular polarization using other kind of structures, and you may agglomerate octave-based resonators into a triangle shape that will be the elementary cell of a multi-frequency array detector, and finally you can group them, creating a kind of fly-eye imager, where it detects everything that happens in an angle of visualization. From the electronic point of view, after you detect the perturbation, you enter into an analog-to-digital converter that is based on a level sensor that recreates the maximum detected level and leaves out a difference between the integer detection versus a signal that is extracted and amplified and put in various stages. And this is how the wavefront looks like. So after you extract that, you give a delay time into an LRC line that reduces the propagation speed, giving time electronics to become stable and getting out of the transitory modes. And that will create a number of bits detected at each stage, and you may apply up to 3 stages with good resolution, giving up to 18-20 bits. To each bit, you may apply correction, a CRC code or hammer for error detection and regeneration. And the competition is analog devices AD9625 that is able to have a few gigasamples per second and a good range and bandwidth. It's a high-performance device that it does about the same as our system is doing. You may get applications in clinical imagery, in lifts, in bio, in cancer detection, in detection of damages in the tooth and molecular modifications inside the tooth, using both transparency and resonant absorption. And here is how it looks in a leaf, the spectrum, before and after watering, and the leaf magnification image. Well, maybe sometimes this technology might work as anticipated, or do even more. Now this project is in technology readiness level 3, and we look forward for more development in order to obtain an advanced technology and rely less on paranormal skills or intuition in medical application, biomedical, and research. Thank you so much for your attention.